Hi. My name is Arthur from England. This course was created by Waleed from Egypt, the founder of 2 Minutes Business Videos channel. He is really excited to be your instructor for this course. Let's get started with this story about Properties Company, a startup real estate company that was planning to buy a vacant commercial building and lease its units for income. At that time, the building had a fair value of 10 million currency. To buy the building, Properties Company was required to pay 6 million currency as a down payment, and the remaining balance after 1 year. Unfortunately, the company did not have enough cash to finance the transaction, so it approached XXX Bank for a loan. But being just a startup company, the bank was very strict in its loan terms, only 50% partial finance of the transaction, with a floating interest rate, and the loan was to be repaid in 1 year. Properties Company knew for sure that it could not live with these terms. So, it thought about leasing as an alternative for buying the building. After negotiations, the owner of the building agreed to sign a non-cancelable operating lease agreement that leased the building to Properties Company for 600,000 currency annually for 10 years. That deal looked great for Properties Company: no down payments, no unpredictable interest rates, no debts on their statement of financial position, and the financial statements will reflect a good image of Properties Company for prospective investors. For these advantages, many companies relied on leasing arrangements as an alternative to conventional financing, and by time, leasing became the fastest growing form of capital investment. Everything went fine. But not for long. Things then turned upside down, and it was a nightmare for many investors because of what was known as off-balance sheet financing. What was that? Let me clarify. Properties Company was committed to pay 600,000 currency annually for 10 years, and if you looked to the substance of the transaction, I mean the operating lease transaction, you would find that these lease payments were actually financial obligations, as the lease transaction was non-cancelable. The statement of financial position of Properties Company did not report any figures for these obligations, and that was okay, as there was no requirement in the accounting standards at that time to recognize an obligation for operating lease transactions. And if you had an eagle-eye view of the whole economy at that time, you would see many companies engaged heavily in operating lease arrangements that involved leasing of airplanes, vehicles, properties, machinery and equipment, and other diverse assets. However, billions of related lease payments obligations for these operating leases were out of the investors' sight. Unaware of these huge obligations, many investors put their cash in Properties Company as well as many other companies, and later, all these companies went bankrupt. The investors discovered that they made the wrong investment decision, because of the non-transparent financials of these companies that did not show the real volume of obligations these companies had. Complaints arose and the IFRS Foundation responded with IFRS 16. Effective 1st of January 2019, IFRS 16 obligates lessees to report operating lease transactions on their statement of financial position. Now investors can easily see a lease liability on the lessee's statement of financial position for almost every lease transaction, along with a right-of-use asset on the asset side. Investors are now aware of the real volume of the lessee's financial obligations before making any investment decisions. So, in this course, you will learn how to account for lease transactions in line with IFRS 16 standard. First, you will learn how to identify a lease in a contract. This is because some contracts might not be straightforward and might be structured in a way that hides the lease transaction. You will see how an asset is identified in the contract, when the lessee has the right to control the use of that asset, and when the supplier's substitution rights are substantive. Then, after identifying a lease in a contract, you will learn how to recognize and measure the lease transaction from the perspective of the lessee. You will learn how to assess the lease term and determine the components of lease payments and the right-of-use asset. Some events might occur after the commencement date of the lease agreement, that might require the lessee to reassess the lease liability. Other times, both the lessee and lessor might agree to modify the lease agreement. You will learn how to account for reassessments of lease liabilities and modifications of lease agreements. Then we will shift to the lessor's side and see the different classifications of leases and how lessors should account for each. Then we will talk about the sale and leaseback transaction and how to account for it. And finally, how to present lease transactions in the financials and what information should be disclosed in the notes to these financials. Now, who is this course for? This course is for accountants and auditors who face difficulty in understanding the standard. They have the basic understanding of financial accounting, for example, journal entries, trial balances, statement of financial position, profit or loss statement, present value calculations, in addition to a basic understanding of how to use Microsoft Excel. You might ask yourself, why should I take this course? Well, Waleed started his career in auditing more than 20 years ago in Arthur Anderson. He got his CPA certification from the US and worked for some time in that field before deciding to take the side of audit clients and join companies working in real estate trading, investment and leasing businesses in the Gulf region, where he held managerial positions in compliance, internal control, then in financial management. At the very beginning of his career, he quickly realized that understanding IFRSs was one of the most challenging tasks for beginners in accounting and auditing fields, even for some experienced colleagues. The highly technical language, the frequent changes in the standards, and Waleed's struggling to complete his day-to-day job assignments, ending up with very little time to do anything else, were the barriers facing him and others in the field. Until today, these barriers are still there. So, he decided to create a course to simplify things for you and save you the time and effort. This course will transform the challenge of understanding IFRS into an easy and enjoyable experience. He used whiteboard animations, which is a very engaging style, as it couples between education and fun, making it easy to understand and memorize what you see. You will see some nice flowcharts, quizzes, screencasts for many examples that illustrate the concepts you are learning. And at the end of each section, you will have PDF summaries of what you have learned and an Excel workbook for all the examples we went through, so that you can work them out yourself. So, after this course, you will be able to assess whether there is a lease in a contract. Separate lease components from non-lease component within a contract. Determine the lease term of identified leases. Account for the lease from the perspective of the lessee and the lessor. Account for sale and leaseback transactions. Present and disclose information about lease transactions. So, let's get started.